Mrs. X started on the pathway of her pregnancy exhausted, with few physical reserves. She hadn't chosen to become pregnant. It was her destiny. The only value she had to her family and community was her ability to produce children. However, Mrs. X had been lucky in a way. At least she'd had a childhood. In some societies, girls are married off while still children themselves, not physically or mentally prepared for childbirth or motherhood. If Mrs. X had been treated as an equal to her brothers while she was growing up, she could have been healthier and better educated. If she'd had more control over her adult life, she may have been able to choose when she had children. As Mrs. X continued her walk through pregnancy, her prospects would have been better if she had visited a skilled professional health worker, a midwife or doctor. Even if Mrs. X had known the importance of antenatal care, her midwife was many miles walk away. If only Mrs. X's problems had been recognized and her anemia treated. If only she'd had specialist care in time. Because of tradition, poverty, and lack of knowledge, many women in Mrs. X's community gave birth at home. Some told stories of being treated harshly and disrespectfully by the hospital staff. Some were expected to pay bribes. Mrs. X had also planned to give birth at home, but then she developed a life-threatening complication. She started to bleed. If Mrs. X had been referred and had transport in time to go to a hospital with facilities for providing comprehensive emergency obstetric care, such as equipment, well-trained staff, and enough medicines and blood, her life and that of her baby might have been saved. Mrs. X could have lived to raise her children. After the long delay in finding transport, Mrs. X was eventually admitted to the hospital, where, due to the lack of resources, she and her baby died. Along the pathway of her pregnancy, Mrs. X faced barriers that prevented her from receiving the care she needed. Each could have been removed. And yet, many or all of these barriers remain along the roads taken by women today. Mrs. X could be any woman. Your sister, your wife, your mother, your daughter. You. It is up to all of us, no matter where we live, who we are, or what we do, to help remove these barriers for Mrs. X and the millions of pregnant women like her. As individuals, we can lobby for better healthcare and equal rights for girls and women. As communities, we can make sure our pregnant women are informed and cared for. We can organize local education, support, and transport for our mothers. As healthcare workers, we can provide quality care in a respectful environment, and we can continue to open the files and learn the lessons from mothers like Mrs. X. As local health planners, we can provide high-quality maternity and family planning services that reach out to more women. And as politicians and policy makers, we can strengthen human rights, we can improve education for girls and women, and we can provide the resources for better, more effective healthcare services across the world, wherever they're needed, now.